The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the course of his preaching, John the Baptist said, "Someone is following me, someone who is more powerful than I am, and I am not fit to kneel down and undo the straps of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." It was at this time that Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee and was baptized in the Jordan by John. No sooner had he come up out of the water than he saw the heavens fall on him, and the Spirit like a dove descending on him, and a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the beloved. My favor rests on you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, it is fitting as we celebrate the baptism of our Lord soon after his birth. Even though there are many years in between these two events, of course, the change from Christmas, where the focus was on the child Jesus, now the focus is on the adult Jesus and also his new beginning. From the incarnation to the ministry of Jesus, Jesus' baptism was the moment where he passed from a relatively private life to a life that is now public, a life that is now people, not only his household, but everyone in the region would come to know this person, Jesus. It is a private stage and a public stage where he comes and proclaims the mission of God. Up to now, few people know Jesus. But because of the crowds were coming to John the Baptist, they were attracted to his teaching. Now, John the Baptist has set the stage for him. And now Jesus comes and John points out that this is the Lamb of God. Follow him. And as people get to hear Jesus preaching, and many of them follow him. Baptism is meant as an acknowledgement of our sins. And also, it helps us to be identified as God's family. So why did Jesus need to be baptized, even though he is the sinless one? And why did Jesus need to be seeking forgiveness of sins, not for our sacrifice, even though he has not committed any sin? Even John the Baptist was a bit puzzled, and Jesus came and asked for baptism. But Jesus told him, "For now, this is fitting, and this is the way that God wanted to be." And through the baptism of the waters of baptism, Jesus descended and he made the waters clean in that sense. Jesus wanted to be in common with us, wanted to be in solidarity with us, because we are sinners. And his desire for us is to be with us, to be among us. Today we have many movements, and one movement that is bringing solidarity. So, solidarity is the Black Lives Movement. We know that this movement has come up against Black people who are voicing out their anger and frustration against the brutality to Black people. But it is not only the Black American people who are protesting or voicing out their concerns, but it's the people of different races and colors, different backgrounds. They are marching hand in hand with these African Americans, speaking out against this brutality. So they are united, they are in solidarity with the Black community. Likewise for Jesus, his solidarity must be with us, so that he can be one of us, and he is one of us. He is not a God that is always up there, but a God who has taken human form to be with us. So that when Jesus descended into the waters, he descended into death, he descended into the sinful world, but as he rose, he came up with new life. And this is the action that we go through our baptism. We die into the sin of origin, and we rise to new life. thank you. Salvation is given to us from a state of damnation to the state that we are now free. We are now saved by this person, Jesus. Baptism is also an entry point to the family of God, where we become adopted sons and daughters of the Father. And this is seen in Jesus' baptism, where the voice was heard from heaven that this is my beloved Son, listen to me. And the dove and sea descending upon him. My dear friends, baptism allows us to be part of God's family. In fact, in the time of Jesus, baptism was very common. It was common for the pagans who wanted to embrace Buddhism. They had to go through this ritual so that it was a mark for them from leaving the old way of pagan life and now embrace Buddhism. But for the Jewish people, because they knew that they were baptized, they were the chosen one, they did not need to go through baptism. And that's a big difference. Because they were chosen, they took it for granted that they will be saved. God will be on their side. Which is true. God has always chosen them for a purpose and for a reason. But the attitude was very different. The attitude was very out there. I'm the chosen race, I'm God's people, thus everyone should bow down to me. But they made a mistake by not fulfilling the role that was given to them. And that role was to share this good news of God with others. Now, the baptism, the purpose of baptism is a symbol also for a new kind of baptism, a baptism of the Holy Spirit. We know that as we are baptized, you know, we are baptized, it's an entry point to God's family. But the Spirit that is upon gives us strength and sustains us in our spiritual life. And we can see this in the life of Jesus when he did his ministry. He was not just doing it by himself, but the Holy Spirit was always with him, for him. And that is why he needed time to pray, to listen, to say, is this what you want me to do, Father? And the Spirit was always there guiding him. In fact, the Spirit was there at his conception. When the angel spoke to Mary, the Holy Spirit . So in that sense, we see the Holy Spirit constantly in the life of Jesus. And that Holy Spirit is given to us at Pentecost. We are given them. And thus we receive the Holy Spirit in our baptism. And we are given and empowered and strengthened by living a life that is a life that is worthy of our call as adopted sons and daughters. Just imagine as children, we can also be like the Jewish people, taking things for granted. I'm really baptized, so I need a life that is different or contradictory to the gospel values. A life that is self-centered, a life that is very egoistic, a life that is always, I don't know about Jesus. I only know him about him when I come to church. That is not the life of the disciple of Christ. The life of the disciple of Christ brings the life that he receives in church into the world. And that's what Jesus did. He was the light that was brought into the dark world so that everyone can see. For us, as we participate in the baptism of Jesus, our goal and mission is very clear. We need to bring this light that we experience every Sunday or every day for some into the world, into your office, into your homes, into the conversations that you have, into the light spaces that you are, your social spaces that you are engaging with. People who have not yet heard about the news. My dear friends, this is a challenge for us. Because we maybe have this idea that as Catholics, we attend Mass and we are saved in that sense. But this is a mistake. The mistake that the Jewish people made. Because they were waiting and they are still waiting for the Messiah. But we know that the Messiah is Jesus. Why? The first reading tells us that Jesus, the Messiah that will come, he will bring joy, peace, restoration, healing. And we see this in the ministry of Jesus. When Jesus healed the leper, when Jesus brought sight to the blind, when Jesus brought life to the widow's son. So we know that this is the Messiah that they have been prophecies in the Old Testament were talking about. But for them, they are still For them, they study because of their spiritual, intellectual knowledge. Jesus cannot be the Messiah. They put God in their books. But God cannot be contained in the books. God cannot be contained in the tabernacle only. He must be brought through. And that is why through baptism, we are commissioned. Not Jewish people, but disciples of Christ. God's people. That's why we are called sons and daughters of the Father to go out and to share the proclaim the good news. So my dear friends, the question for us today as we reflect on the baptism of Jesus, what kind of life are we living? What kind of life are we living? We can be very devotional, that is good. But is that all? I think it's very important to reflect on our life because we reflect who we are, right? If you're a boss, the way you behave, the way you have your meals is different. You know, many people always think that meals fit, they enjoy cheese, wine, and smoked cigar. Then I think you can put them for the French pizza. But for the local meals myself, I don't smoke cigar. I don't smoke cigar. I don't drink wine. I take cheese up, but craft cheese up. And to the French people, craft cheese is rubbish cheese. When we put people in a box, we can't see the mystery of God. Because we have made assumptions of them. And that is very foolish in a sense. Because we don't see the wisdom of God. The first reading tells us to seek God's wisdom, to come close to Him. What is it telling us? It's telling us that we can always call upon God to help us to discern His will, to discern what is appropriate in our way of life, the way of life that we are living. It's a seeking of God's will. So let us pray, my dear friends. Knowing that we are baptized, the challenge is how do we live our life? Do we want to depend on the Spirit of God? Or do we want to depend on our human spirit? If you know that our human spirit will always bring us death. Our human spirit will always bring us selfishness. Our human spirit will always bring up our evil. So let us pray. Our model for us is Jesus. If Jesus lived the Spirit in that way, we too are called to live a life of the Spirit in the way of Christ. Continue to pray, continue to discern the will of God. It takes time. It is not an overnight thing, but it takes time to discern the Spirit of God. And through this discernment of the Spirit of God, we will continue to be more and more like children of the Father. Amen.
Amen.